Mother, she doesn't like me wearing them. She can't stand the damn things. I mean, if I was to wear them and nothing else, it wouldn't leave much of the imagination, would it?
Why'd you wear these dirty clothes?
Well, going out partying, like, you know. You go out on a run, like, you know, you've probably got 200 or 300 miles to cover. Oh, why ruin a good pair of jeans? Put these over the top, let them take all the shit. Can't you? Can always tell a guy who does a lot of riding as well from his ridges. Because I've been doing too much just lately, and these, you can see the denim underneath. But a guy who's doing the riding, especially if he's got a British bike, these are all bottoms are just covered in oil and shit. But then the last time I wore these, I was riding back to Lincolnshire. Got quite a bloody downpour. 5 years of hard work and filth washed away. That is a set of colours. These. They're called rockers. Top rocker, your bottom rocker. Your top rocker being the name of your club. The bottom rocker letting you know where you're from. The MC, your motorcycle club. The centre patch, we're Outcasts, so that's Airhead. If you've got a prospect, you get a bottom rocker. And that's only after you've been hanging around for a while, because we won't even give you that if we don't think you're worth it. Because although you haven't actually got the Outcast name, you're still wearing the bottom rocker, and we've got to know that if you're going to sport our colours, then you've got to be worth it. You know, you've got to be worth every ounce of your shit, so to speak.
I think she's angry.
She ain't.
She?
No.
Hello. Hello, baby. Hello, my poor lady.
To join, you've got to be, your face has more or less got to fit. You've got to be able to mix with them, be friendly with them. You know, don't start hassles with the other bros, like.
You have an hanging around period, and after the members get to know you, the members vote you in. And then you have to prospect from there. And then it's down to me when you get your patch, or if you get your patch.
I've sort of helped President with his bikes, you know, clean them down, be at places, you know, at the meetings. If I miss a meeting, then probably get my ass kicked and a fine. And just be where he says to be.
He is a general dog's body. He does everything and anything that members in the club tell him to do. like, for instance, you test them on their the violence capabilities.
A lot of people sort of like brand them as sort of like animals and, you know, filthy lot of heathens, but they're just like anybody else.
We've thrown them off cliffs. We've thrown them into fires. We've met them generally sit in front of fires with fuck all on, man, and scorch. We've done all sorts to them, man.
Thank you.
trade, trade, trade. Your bones, dinner, dinner, never bust a race. A famous great man, cook up with me, claimer and a bull, and join the Megan stay, and the fiery horde of power on the face.
What kind of business are you in?
Well, I restore sports cars, but I do sort of other customers' cars for them, especially for people on the industrial estate.
You're an outcast?
Yeah. Proud to be one. Your average person thinks that anybody wears a leather jacket is bad, which is not the case. But reflecting on a business side, anybody who wears a leather jacket, and especially got a patch on their back, and is in business, business would go downhill. The advantages of having a workshop like what I've got is anybody else in the club who needs facilities for doing things to their bikes, they've got the facilities here, all the equipment. They can get their bikes done a lot quicker now than what they used to. Instead of working in a shed in the back of a garden somewhere, they can get the bike over here, build it up, get it done on the road, and it costs them a lot less in time and aggravation. And they let them work on their bikes in the evening and on Sundays. During the day, even my bike is covered up and in a corner because of the image, because I have customers come here every day. Potential customers want to spend 1,500 quid plus on a car. So if they see bikers in here, it's going to go downhill.
We look after our area. Any other bike club can come into our area, whereas with other Hell's Angel clubs or with other outlaw clubs, you cannot go into their area. If you go into their area, you get stumped. You get busted.
At the moment, we're pretty hard up because, we're just getting a weekly unemployment benefit. By the time I pay me rent and fines, that leaves me with about £7 a week to buy me food and everything else with. You can't even live unless people, relatives and that give me food and that every week. If it weren't for that, then we'd starve. Yeah, we all signed on as normal. When we walked out here, there was two plainclothes policemen standing at the road opposite that shop there. And as I got to about here, they walked over the road and got me by the arm, took me across the road to that shop number 14 over there, where we was all cautioned and made a small statement, and then they kept us there until there was about...
No news to me from Bobby is good news. It's when I hear from him I'm worried, because I know then that there's something wrong. Because you never hear from Bobby, you see, if he's all right. It had only been a matter of about a week, I could cry now when I think about it, that I was giving that lad a cup of tea there. I knew Wolf, and he went back with Bob. And then I got this phone call. It upsets me a bit, this. And he phoned and he says he'd been killed. It was the way he died, you know. It upset me. He says, "Mam, if only he'd died on his bike."
I used to be an ABA boxer. I trained for the Lincoln Imps in Scunthorpe. I'm just trying to get rid of some of the fat off my gut. Get me out together again and then start doing some serious fighting. The rest of the club are all into it. They're all doing their own training.
I met Tetra and he gave me two of the front patches just as a bond of a friendship. And he said, I'll make you an honorary member of the club to a seal our friendship.
They're no different to any other customers. The usual comments we've got is, oh, you know, horrible, hairy, dirty, smelly bikers. You get close to them, the only smell you get is it's petrol. I had a bit of a gutter tramp one night. He was talking about having a bath. I said, you'll ruin your reputation. And he actually got upset about it. You know, here's a guy that has at least one, if not two, baths a day. Because of the way he dresses, he's got this reputation, you know. And it's totally unwarranted, actually.